You see, throughout the ages, philosophers, theologians, people of religion and people of no religion have been challenging, asking this question, is there anything called free will? Because we believe in the law of cause and effect. Everything we can even think about has been fashioned the way, depending on the way we are brought up. So our nature and our nurture will dictate the way we think. We can't think outside the box. So everything I think and the thought that I have now has been fashioned by the way I've been brought up, what I've read, what I've interacted with. So it cannot come out of nowhere. So as you believe in the idea of law of cause and effect, things are connected, interconnected. So that means that everything we think about as you know, my own thought is really perhaps chiseled by the way I was brought up, including my own hardware, you know, the DNA that I possess kind of fixes the way I think. So is there anything called the free will left? Because maybe everything is fixed up. So what's the point? The answer is very interesting. It says that the way you distinguish a living thing from a non-living thing is precisely this. A non-living, there's a very elaborate computer. It can almost mimic a human being. And yet the thing that is lacking there is this, the computer doesn't feel it's got a free will. Even though you may program it to feel it is, it's not genuine. It's artificially motivated. So every living thing, not only human beings, seem to have something within the system that makes them think, yes, this is my own decision. I'm making a decision from a moment to moment. That is a sign of life. So free will is a sign of the spirit, a sign of life. We are not something that's come out of material kingdom. If we are, we have no free will. Because there's something more to us than matter, or just a this complex matter that we kind of live in, then there is the idea of free will. Yes. Every moment, every second, you feel you are free to think, even though you might be kind of, the way you think has already been chiseled, and yet you feel you are free. And this constant struggle to break free from the, we feel like the physical and the mental limitation we possess is called free will. It's a sign of the spirit, a sign of a living thing.
Free e-learning course in Hinduism. To register, please visit www.hindu-academy.com.
Talks on Hinduism, sponsored by People Care, encouraging caring for the elderly in their own homes. For more information, please visit peoplecare.com.